Hi everybody, welcome to Math Theory. And in today's class, we are going to discuss one of the famous problem of derivative, that is the half derivative. Half derivative of x. So let's get started. To understand this concept, we will start from first derivative of x raised to n. X raised to n is a function, and if we have to differentiate it with respect to x, what would be its derivative? Its derivative would be this. And suppose we have to differentiate the second derivative of the same function. Second derivative means two times differentiation. It means one more time differentiate this function. So n and x to the power n minus 1, when it would be differentiated, it would be this. If we differentiate the same function with respect to x again, then continue this process and it would be this. If we want to generalize this process, then kth derivative of x raised to n is what? For third derivative, n minus 1 n minus 2, for third derivative up to n minus 2, 3 2, what is the relation? 2 is 3 minus 1. So for kth derivative, n minus 1 n minus 2, and it would be continue till n minus k plus 1. Actually it is n minus k minus 1, and minus would be multiplied inside, then it would be n minus, for third derivative n minus 3, so for kth derivative n minus k. This is the kth derivative of x raised to n. The kth derivative of x raised to n is n minus 1 n minus 2 n minus k plus 1 x2 raised to n minus k. n minus 1 n minus 2 dash 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 3 to 1 is n factorial, but this is not up to 3 to 1. It is this term we already have, and you have to multiply n minus k factorial and divide by the same quantity n minus k factorial, and x raised to n minus k is already there. So we can write the kth derivative of x raised to n is n minus k plus 1 n minus 2. So these terms are actually n factorial, because we learned that n into n minus 1 factorial is n factorial itself. So in the same way, n minus 1, these terms would be making n factorial. And this term x raised to n minus k is already there by n minus k factorial. So this is kth derivative of x raised to n. Kth derivative of x raised to n is nothing but this. Question is half derivative of x. So if we reuse this relation, kth derivative, and here is half derivative. What function is given? X raised to n, but we want x. So in this relation, if we put n is equals to 1 and k is equals to 1 by 2. So if we substitute n equals to 1 and k equals to half in this relation, so it would be how it would change. It would be n is 1, so 1 factorial is 1, x raised to n minus 1 minus half. 1 minus half by 1 minus half, 1 minus half factorial, 1 minus half factorial, and x raised to 1 minus half is half itself, and 1 minus half is half factorial, 1 minus half is half factorial. As we know that factorial can be determined for only integers, but gamma function can be determined for fractions. So if we could convert this factorial into gamma function, it would be easy to find. Now what is gamma function? As we know that the gamma function गामा एन इज इक्वल्स टू एन माइनस वन फैक्टोरियल. हाउ गामा इज रिलेटेड विथ फैक्टोरियल? बिकॉज फैक्टोरियल इज वेल नोन कंसेप्ट एंड इट इज ईजी टू अंडरस्टैंड फॉर ऑल. बट गामा फंक्शन इफ आई रिलेट विद द फैक्टोरियल, सो गामा एन इज एन माइनस वन फैक्टोरियल. इट मीन्स इफ आई हैव टू सॉल्व गामा एन प्लस वन, इट इज एन गामा एन. वन मोर डेफिनेशन ऑफ गामा फंक्शन इज गामा एन प्लस वन इज एन 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 गामा एन. एंड द क्वेश्चन इज हाउ हाफ फैक्टोरियल वी कुड सॉल्व. सो इफ वी यूज दिस रिलेशन दैट इफ वी वॉन्ट एन फैक्टोरियल एंड इफ वी वॉन्ट टू कन्वर्ट इट इन गामा, सो एन फैक्टोरियल इज एन प्लस वन गामा. एन फैक्टोरियल इज एन प्लस वन गामा. सो आर क्वेश्चन इज हाफ फैक्टोरियल, हाफ फैक्टोरियल. सो इफ वी यूज दिस, दिस हाफ प्लस वन गामा. हाफ फैक्टोरियल इज नथिंग बट हाफ प्लस वन, दैट इज थ्री बाई टू गामा. एंड थ्री बाई टू गामा वी कैन कैलकुलेट इजिली. हाउ? बाई यूजिंग दिस डेफिनेशन ऑफ गामा. गामा एन प्लस वन इज एन गामा एन. सो गामा थ्री बाई टू इज सी एन प्लस वन गामा इज एन. सो थ्री बाई टू गामा इज थ्री बाई टू माइनस वन. द बेसिक property of gamma is like you want to solve it gamma 5. So what you would do, you would subtract 1 because gamma 5 is 4 factorial. So gamma 5 you want to calculate, then first you subtract 1. So 4, 3, 2, 1. But if rest of the value you don't know, then you can write gamma 4 is 4 gamma 4. But the question is how to solve gamma 3 by 2. So gamma 3 by 2 is 3 by 2 minus 1. 3 by 2 minus 1 is nothing but half. And now half, from half if you again subtract 1, then it would be negative. And negative gamma cannot be found. So for gamma half, you must be knowing it is root pi. So it is half root pi. Gamma 3 by 2 is half root pi. So now we know its value. It is x raised to half by gamma 3 by 2. And gamma 3 by 2 we can put. So by this explanation, we can say that the half derivative of x is x raised to half means root x. And half factorial is nothing but gamma 3 by 2. Half factorial is gamma 3 by 2. 5 factorial is gamma 6. 7 factorial is gamma 8. So half factorial is gamma 3 by 2. And gamma 3 by 2 is 1 by 2 into root pi. 1 by 2 into root pi. So finally the half derivative of x is 2 root x by root pi. So half derivative of x is 2 root x by root pi. So in same way, not only half derivative of x, but we can find half derivative of x square or any power of x we can find by this relation which we have already derived. This relation we have substituted n is equals to 1 and k is equals to half. Not only half derivative but any fractional derivative of x, x square, x cube we can find. I hope this video is helpful for you. For more such videos, subscribe my channel Maths is Easy. Thank you for watching.